Africa is most vulnerable to climate change due to existing levels of extreme poverty many Africans face on a daily basis, and its heavy dependence on rainfall and other natural resources, as agriculture is its most important economic sector, making climate change adaptation a key component toward sustainable development.
In Ghana, we've tried to identify Vodafone, a telecommunication provider. They are into mobile phones. And what we've done is we've lined them up with this adaptation program in developing simple messages for the people where the early warning system program is going to be. Therefore, when there's going to be a drought, a flood, they could be able to send it through their mobile phones. If even they cannot read, at least the pictograms could tell them what is going to happen. This is an example where a private-public partnership could be evolved.
Research shows that Africa is on average 0.5 degrees Celsius warmer than it was 100 years ago, and temperatures have risen much higher in some areas like here in Kenya, which has become 3.5 degrees Celsius hotter in the past 20 years. Environmental groups warn that droughts in Africa are getting worse and climate uncertainty is growing. As ordinary citizens here in Nairobi and around the world have begun to see the dramatic changes in our climate, the media plays a crucial role in providing useful information to effectively guide public debate and understanding of climate change issues. Climate change is an urgent topic that is currently not well understood by the general public. In parts of Africa, Asia, and Latin America, the quality and quantity of climate change articles are growing but are generally read by wealthier urban dwellers. And there is still little research available on how much information is reaching poorer communities.
With South News, I think that with your coverage, we need that kind of support to be able to move the agenda to all our key stakeholders. And South News, I feel that it will play a very key role in trying to disseminate useful information, sharing South experiences among these countries who are involved in this program.
Decision makers are meeting in Cancun, Mexico through December 10th at the United Nations Climate Change Conference to discuss the urgent issues brought about by climate change and to make united decisions on the way forward to assist countries and businesses in moving toward low-carbon, climate-resilient, sustainable growth.
As soon as you make the media understand the subject matter, which is how dire it is that they communicate climate change, the process of communication is going to be much better, and it's going to be spread farther afield and in terms and language and in the way that the media places things. So first of all, I appreciate this meeting because that is what they have come to do, increase that capacity, not only in understanding, but give them tools of communication to be able then to bring a very difficult subject, a very a real problem in the world, a universal problem, to a local level.
The media's key objective is to improve the dissemination of information on climate change so that it is easily understood by all, including policymakers and the general public. Afaf Kanja, South News, Nairobi.